Hello, I'm Marta, I come from Poland. And today I would like to speak about my top three reasons why I think a vegan diet is a sustainable food solution. First of all, I want to start with very school-like with the definition what I think best describes sustainable food. And that will enable you to understand what I'll be and why I'll be talking about today. First of all, I think the sustainable food would be a production of food that is using techniques that will protect our environment, public health, and protect the animal welfare for the well-being of our current and obviously future generations. First of all, I'm going to start about the environment very briefly. There have been several documentaries that has told about the very interesting and quite shocking figures how animal agriculture has a damaging impact on our planet. And these are, first of all, that was shocking for me was the gas emission that in animal agriculture is a few times higher than all sort of transportation gas emission put together. I would like to encourage you to look those details, the details up when you're home. These are also details from United Nations reports. Because I would like to go right now to the second topic, which is the protection of our health, which is much closer to my heart. Around 4 years ago, I have my youngest son was just over one, the other one was three. I have probably been on the lowest level of my health. I have been struck with severe migraines that were just getting worse and worse. I used to have terrible headaches. I lost a lot of weight because of vomiting during migraines. I have been constantly tired. I have no energy to do any sort of sports, and I used to do a lot of sports. But I have also two little kids at home, so that wasn't helping. We used to also get sick very often, whether there was this flu season or not. When kids go to school, they all already got sick, and we've been stuck at home for days until we recover. But there was something that was happening normally around me. Whenever I talk to any mom at school, oh, the kids are also sick because it's the flu season or there is a spring coming. So that wasn't anything that would let me think about a little bit more about food. But then when my youngest son was 1.5 years old, he was diagnosed with autoimmune disease. And I decided I was desperately on a mission that we should do something at home that would help him to deal better with the disease and maybe let him body heal. And I was reading tons of books about nutrition, and every single one of them was leading me to the plant-based diet that's supposed to be the healthiest diet for humans. It has been proven that it has reversed some of the common diseases and slowly wean off ourselves from any animal products. Within a few weeks, we already noticed one of the biggest benefit was the new energy levels. And back then I wasn't thinking about it, but a carnivore animal, when it eats meat, it goes to sleep for a few hours or even a few days. It same happens to human body. We eat a meal with big portion of meat, and then we just sleepy, and then we probably drink three coffees to keep ourselves alive because we have to work, we have kids. Second of all, definitely noticeable as a mom of two young kids, the immune system got so much better that during the weaning off meat process of 3 months, when the first winter came, my children actually didn't get sick for the first time. And then in the last 4 years, touch wood, we've been barely sick, but if we did, it was very quick recovery. It was a matter of one afternoon, and then they could go to school the next day. So actually, they never missed a school day because of the sickness in the last 4 years. Definitely, what I want to say, like, my skin got better and we have better sleep. My parents decided to take on a plant-based diet, and my dad, under a night of his doctor, within a few months, he got rid of his heart medication, and because his blood pressure regulated just by itself, but using a healthy vegan diet, because that's what I want to indicate, it's a healthy vegan diet, not junk food vegan diet. And he took this medication for 15 years every single day. And now, suddenly, after a few months, he doesn't need it anymore. And it's been over 3 years when he's on a plant-based diet, and he still doesn't need to take his medication. My mom dropped her cholesterol within 4 months. She goes for very regular checkups. And she raised her iron without eating any meat, which is quite shocking for her doctor. The last thing that I want to mention is the animal welfare. There's a lot of facts about how we treat the wildlife, but I just want to briefly tell about that if we switch to a plant-based diet, we could save billions of animals, and the right number is in billions, because these are the amount of animals that are being purely slaughtered to turn into meat. And these are animals who are born in the slaughterhouses, and their purpose of life is to be basically turned into a meal. And this somehow became normal and very standardized because we don't see it. We don't talk about it. That's why I'm here to just want to raise it a little bit. When we change our diet, we have to explain our kids why we're eating differently. We just basically explain to them where the food is coming from. We use very gentle, child-friendly language. And when they find out you have to hurt an animal to make a sausage or bacon, they didn't want to touch it anymore. They didn't understand. They asked me questions like, do other people know about it? Like, do you have to hurt an animal? Well, I said, yeah, but we tend to ignore it as adults. And adults also have a lot of excuses, but because we love the taste of bacon in the morning with eggs. Children don't have that. If they see an animal, they want to cuddle all animals. For them, they're very lovable beings. The last thing what I want for you to take home is to try to introduce a vegan meal at least once a week. I can definitely help you with recipes. I run a food blog. And I just want to assure you that there is a possibility to have a full of nutrition, but also very delicious vegan meal. And I've managed to a little bit lie to my family, and they thought I'm making sweet pea soup. And there was the one magic ingredient, which was the smoked paprika powder that smells like bacon. I just want to, I hope I inspired you a little bit today, and I hope we can talk about it later. Thank you.